One of the benefits of lists is that their length can grow and shrink over the course of a program. But that means it can be useful to find the length of a list at a given point in time. You can get the length for a list like this, numlist.length. When your program runs, the computer will replace this with the current length of the list. In this case, the length of the list is 6. A potential point of confusion is that even though the length of the list is 6, the last index is 5. This is because we start the indexing at 0. Because lists change size, a common issue in programming with lists is, what's the index of the last element? We typically find out using the expression list.length minus 1, and you frequently see it used to access the last element of the list like this, numlist, and in square brackets, numlist.length minus 1. Lists are a very powerful way to store and maintain data in programs. They open the door for us to write programs that use and process lots and lots of information, especially when we don't know ahead of time just how much information needs to be stored. Let's try them out.